Welcome to day two of our first Look Week of webisodes. Do want to tell you that here at Paper Wishes, we think you're the cat's meow.
And the bee's knees.
What are we talking about? We have a new paper collection called the Charleston, and it has wonderful elements in it.
It does. Brand new papers, dazzles, ribbons, matching buttons, paper toll, a big collection.
All sorts of things. And wait till you see what the design team has done.
Come play with us.
And here is the whole collection, all sorts of goodies.
Nice big collection.
Now the papers are, they're 12 by 12. The project are on the newsletter, on the insert.
Right here, right.
Yeah, and so there's scrapbook page, there's cards, information there.
But you can see there's some rich kind of darker tones.
Gorgeous.
And you'll be able to see all these in detail on the product video.
Right.
So we can get into projects.
Exactly.
So we've got the papers, we've got ribbons that match, custom made for those. And lots of fun designs in there. I just want to show there's glittery stuff. So, of course, they're always going to match perfectly.
And the flowers we selected have the golden touch, so really pretty.
We have dazzles. These are 88 Charleston dazzles with lots of fun images in here. And you're going to see lots of these images right here on the project.
Right. And then we've brought two older products, not terribly old, but two existing products that go with this. And look how those buttons match perfectly.
They really do. They're perfectly suited for this.
It's called Farmhouse. And as you know, there's buttons, sequins, beads, all sorts of goodies right in there.
Right.
And the letterpress paper toll. So elements there. So you can see just a wonderful collection. But let's get into the goodies.
Let's do that.
Our first card by Teresa is this. And you can see how beautiful those dazzles are with those edges.
I agree with that. The beautiful brown dazzles, which you'd think brown, what's so great about that? But when you put gold right next to it, it's just a perfect look with those papers.
It really is. Now, there is a stamp set. It's Art Nouveau. We're going to do that as a separate webisode. But Teresa has used some of the smaller elements in this particular
Embossed in gold that matches it perfectly. Yeah. And again, just used here. You can see the papers are really focused on and just a few of the smaller dazzles, but they make a really nice impact.
Now in this card, oh by the way, the scrapbookers, there's going to be scrapbook pages, so don't go away. So you can see what she's done. This is the paper toll, and this is one big piece, and as you know, those are die cut and numbered. You just layer them with foam tape.
Right. So on the sheet, you're always going to get three separate images here, but they're all stackable. So here's one, here's one, and here's one. But what I think is interesting about this card is that you can also split them apart because they look great on their own. These particular paper toll, you can do them individually.
Let's leave that just for a second. Okay. So the love that's there, or the love.
Love, yeah,
is
love.
Used right here.
Right.
Now, on the inside, she has used the other
rest
two
of the
layers.
Elements, right? So these two stacked on top. Plus, there's the extra little baubles here that you can stack on top of there.
And she's used those too. So very, very pretty. And again, you can see how gorgeous those great big focals are.
Nice.
Now, we're going back to the cat's meow. Okay, so what does the cat's meow mean? Well, we've done some research for you.
Okay.
The cat's meow in cat's pajamas means exciting, excellent, has a style to it, and a little bit sexy. I'm just telling you.
So if we're thinking about the dazzles, I guess we'll think about that because we've got this beautiful 1920s style lady there.
Stylish,
right?
Just excellent, very fun. A little paper toll right down there.
So mixing the dazzles with the paper toll. So check that out. So some of the extra artwork pieces from the paper toll placed on top of that label and some backed dazzles for the leaves.
And on the inside, isn't that pretty? Just gorgeous.
Nice
very,
little
very
opening
nice.
There for your own greeting or whatever you want to say.
Now, Teresa did a very fun thing here in creating a window.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just so stylish. So, this is the cat's meow.
It is.
and you're the bee's knees. Okay, let me tell you about the bee's knees.
Okay.
It is cool. It's the height of excellence. It's sweet and good. Now, there's another one that didn't quite make the test of time, and it was the eel's ankle.
The eel's ankle.
Yeah, I just...
I'm really glad we didn't put that on the dazzles.
Me too. Okay.
But in this one, the window is really kind of unique, and when we look at that window, you'll see, and I'm going to turn it over this way, you'll see the cutout, but there's no you know, that you can see the dazzles popping through. And so I want to show you just how Teresa did that. This is one of Teresa's cards, and she had kind of an interesting, easy technique for getting that window accomplished. I've got my card, I've got it covered with paper. So here are the dazzles. I'm going to take this window piece and I'm going to place it on my card, but because dazzles can be sort of picked up and removed a couple of times, then I'm not going to press it down hard and I'm going to use it as a template. So let me just place it on, kind of trying to center it here up at the top. If I take a little bit more time, I know I can do that just right. But there, so now I know where I want my window to be, and I get out a pencil and I just use the pencil to trace that diamond area. So this is really simple to do. And I mean, you're looking at that window with the dazzle going, how in the world did she cut that out
and
not
cut
the dazzles?
And please tell me she didn't cut into those tiny areas.
Right, well then you lift it off, like so.
Okay.
Now you've still got your dazzle to place on this afterwards. So I'm gonna actually turn it over so I don't have to get it stuck to anything else. And then I would open my card, get out my retractable pen knife, and now that I have these lines here, I can just cut that window open.
Just that diamond.
Right. And once that is an open window, I'll be able to go back to my dazzle and place it right around that window, and you'll have the effect.
Now, something else that Teresa did, this window is a little fancier than the one you showed, but she's added other dazzles onto it.
That's
so just
right.
To make it even more.
That's right. The dazzles here, it doesn't have that top and bottom mm-hmm. image, but that's what's
gorgeous.
Great about all of those extra little elements on here that you can add. And then on the inside, she backed a square on paper, and so that just fits perfectly behind that window. And so, what fun.
Just gorgeous.
I like that.
Now, you may want to put a little baby powder or something on the back of these.
Even better.
Okay.
You can use the printing pouch, and that's why I had it sitting here, because once you get it on there, you can see that those dazzles are sort of, you know, they might stick to the inside of the card, so just pounce on them with a little of this. And it takes care of all of the stickiness.
Okay, and isn't that fun with those chains hanging down?
Beautiful.
Very, very neat.
It's like beads. Really neat.
Gorgeous. Mm-hmm. And this is another window card using some of the same elements, a larger one, letting those two focals just go to each other.
Right.
And this is an easel
card. Two cameos, right. And this is kind of fun, and I was going to show how to make this, but then I didn't know for sure we were going to show the card, and I wish I would have. But so here you have, you know, a standard card, first of all, a 5-inch by 6.5-inch card, but you've got that window there. And to do that, I made this extra panel, and I used like an ivory cardstock. I made a panel, covered it with paper, and then I glued it to the bottom half of the front of that card, just like an easel, and then I cut the window. So it was cutting through that front panel and through the easel panel, through both layers there, and it made that nice window.
Beautiful, really, really nice.
Okay,
scrapbookers, here you go. Now, what's nice about the Charleston papers is that they can do heritage photos beautifully.
Of course.
So this is all dolled up, really, really just fun statement.
I absolutely love this surrounding that journaling.
Me
so
too.
Go ahead and do some journaling on with your computer printer, or do hand journaling onto cardstock or paper, and then place the dazzle on it, cut around the outside edge, and it's just perfectly framed.
And this background sheet comes exactly as you see. We haven't added any other papers other than the one in the center for that supersized mat.
Right,
so
just
really
beautiful.
Pretty.
I love the borders always come in 6-inch pieces.
Mm-hmm.
You can go all the way across, or you can do a little bit at the top, a little bit at the bottom, and just beautiful.
It's really nice. Now, for heritage photos, but also for today's photos. So that's what's really nice about these papers. They just have such a wonderful quality.
Right. You don't have to have a grandma from the 1920s or something.
It's not required.
Photos. Not required. You can totally use your beautiful photos with those gorgeous flowers. Those are so pretty. And she's added a lot of the pearls, the sequins, etc.
Right.
From the farmhouse
and
buttons.
Over here, the buttons.
So, right. So it's got all of that in there. And you can see they match just perfectly. Beautiful.
So you can proudly hold your head high and know that you are the bee's knees and the cat's meow.
Absolutely.
And we're for you, and we've got you covered.
And we've got you covered tomorrow, too, yes. So we'll see you then.
Please join us.